Hey everybody, this is Brad from Johnson Small Engines, better known as the One Hand Mechanic. If I can do it, you can too. Working on a Briggs and Stratton engine. You can see it's on the table here. It is a model number 33R877, type number 002-0002-G1, and the code is a 140212ZD. This is going to be how to adjust your valves on a single cylinder Briggs and Stratton engine. Most overhead valve Briggs and Stratton engines are going to be very similar to this, but their valve lash is going to be a little bit different. I just wanted to show you the front of this before I turned it around to get to the back part of it where we're going to show you how to do the valves. Valves are up in here. The reason why this machine is actually, this engine's on the bench is because there is, I'm pretty sure there's a bad cam inside here. And I just want to make sure that there's a couple different reasons why I'm going to show you guys how to adjust the valves, but also you need to adjust the valves, make sure that the valves are adjusted properly to properly diagnose the cam being bad inside the motor. Okay, so right now I'm going to show you some tools. We have, of course, everybody knows my 1/4-inch ratchet, electric ratchet that I use. We're going to need a 5/8 wrench for adjusting them and also a feeler gauge. Now, it's 4/1000ths or 0.102 millimeters. That's what I'm going to use. It's supposed to be 3 to 5 thousandths on the intake and exhaust, and I'm going to make it a happy medium 4. I'm going to use a 1/4-inch driver, a handheld driver that's going to go to a Torx, a T20 Torx is what you're going to need for the valves too. And I am going to use a long skinny screwdriver to put down the spark plug hole to get top dead center. And I know there's a lot of guys out there that say don't use something metal, but believe it or not, it says it right in the instructions in the Briggs and Stratton manual. So you can use a, you know, if you're careful, you can just be careful and you'll be able to use it fine. 5/8 deep spark plug socket to get the spark plug out with a 3/8 ratchet. Also have a 1/4-inch extension here on a 3/8 socket, and this is a 5/8 socket on a 1/2 inch. It's a 1/2 inch 5/8 socket on a 1/2 inch ratchet that we're going to use to turn the engine over. So we're going to go back over to the engine now, and as you can see, I have a bolt here for the crankshaft. Now I've already tightened this bolt up into the crankshaft, and it's just so we can turn this engine over to get top dead center. We're going to first take the spark plug out, and you're going to use your 5/8 spark plug socket, and you're going to take this out with the ratchet. Now I've already had it for the purpose of this video. We're going to just do it by hand, but do know that you need that 5/8 deep socket, which is a spark plug socket, to take this out. And pretty much all these spark plugs are the RC12YCs that you get. I use an NGK product. Okay, so now we have it at, we have the hole open there. We want to take off our valve cover here. The top bolts are 3/8. And some of them are 10 millimeter, but I'm pretty sure 3/8 works on all of them. And you just want to take these out. Sealer covers, they actually use a silicone sealer now instead of the gasket. And we were already in this to check the valves when it was on the machine before I put it on the bench. All right, so when you take your cover off, it may be extremely hard to take this cover off, and you may need to use a chisel, and you got to be very careful where you put the chisel to get these up. And you're probably going to have, we have the gasket here because we already had this back together again, because the first thing we had to do is check valve clearances. But I'd like to use the Briggs and Stratton gasket. I do not have a part number for you today for that, but you can easily look that up on a parts breakdown. Okay, so here are your valves, and we're gonna have to get this up at top dead center. Okay, so we put a bolt. This bolt is from the crank, This is the crankshaft bolt for the double pulley that was on the engine when we had the engine in the tractor. And so I put this in here, and we tightened it up pretty good. And you can use an impact, I guess, to put a little more tension on there, but we just gotta make sure this is tight so we can turn over the engine. And you are gonna be turning over that engine counterclockwise. I'm gonna put my skinny screwdriver in here, and yes, you can use a skinny screwdriver. Just be careful, okay? That's all you gotta do. Now, I'm just gonna be using it for the process of the up and down on the piston, and as with one hand, it's gonna be a little more tricky for me than you guys, but you wanna go counterclockwise, and I'm gonna show you the strokes, and we wanna be at top dead on the compression stroke with about a 1/4-inch lap on that. So right now, we're gonna go down on the, I'm pretty sure it's on the intake, okay, so the So right now we're pretty much at top dead. We're gonna go down on the intake. Okay, so we got intake. Okay, then compression's coming up. And then we have power going back down. And then exhaust, as you can see, the exhaust is open up over there, because these have, we have intake and exhaust. And you can always tell your exhaust is that your exhaust valve is right next to your exhaust port for your exhaust muffler. Okay, so always remember that. If you're always wondering what's intake and what's exhaust, so you have exhaust here and intake here. And then we're going back up to intake. So right now we're gonna be down again, just watching these valves move, and just pay attention as that intake compression's coming up. So we wanna be top dead on a compression stroke. And I'm gonna keep going just to show you that this is the power stroke going down. And then we have the exhaust coming up. And as you can see, the exhaust valve is closing. So we have to go down one more time. We're gonna be intake and then compression coming up. And this is where we wanna be. So when that screwdriver hits top dead center, right? Top dead is right about there, okay? I go over a little bit. So your crankshaft is gonna be at top dead, which is straight up and down, but then it just bumps over just a tick. That's where you wanna be. And you can feel that, because if you try to go back up to top dead, it wants to go one way or the other. All right, so it's, you can see this crankshaft right now. If I try to move it right there at top dead, it wants to go one side or the other. Just make sure you're counterclockwise, and so you just have it a bump over, okay? And once that's top dead center, a compression stroke. Okay, so we're gonna adjust the valves, and we're gonna use our 220 Torx. I'm gonna put this on a hand ratchet, just makes it easier for me. And also a 5/8, your feeler gauges, of course, and your 5/8 wrench. All right, so what you wanna do is, basically you wanna unlock these guys here by using the Torx, they call it like a ball screw in the center. And so you just, if you loosen this guy up, okay, it doesn't really matter, loosen them both up to adjust these. And I wanna go with the set 4/1000s because it's supposed to be 3/5000s and I like 4.5 medium. So get these guys nice and loose, all right? Now, the hard part is going to be doing this on the machine, because what I'm going to do here is pretty easy when it's on the bench, is that I'm just going to set the 4/1000s feeler gauge inside there, then I'm going to tighten down the locking nut there, or actually the nut, and it's actually the locking Torx on top. Now, once this is snug, you have to use your 5/8 wrench and hold it, and you have to hold that very tight in a one spot, and you're going to tighten up the Torx ball screw, and you don't want to... loose, you don't want to have that wrench move the nut at all. Once that's tight, then you back out your gauge and it should be pretty close. Now this is a little bit on the loose side, so I'm going to do that one more time, which means that I'm just going to loosen up the ball screw, the Torx, and then I'm going to just by hand tighten that up. Now I snugged it up pretty good that time, put the 5/8 on there, and I'm going to hold a little tension on it, and then we're gonna tighten that up, nice and snug. See how it is now. Feels a little tighter. We're gonna pull this out and we're gonna see if it goes in. And it does take a little wiggling. Okay, so that's a little on the snug side, but we also have 3/5000, so it's at 4, and that's pretty much perfect for that one. So this one here is loose, it's very loose. I'm gonna do it on this one. And I'm just gonna set that in there. And like I said, on the bench, I can do this. In fact, I'm actually gonna move it like that. And then we're gonna tighten this guy up by hand. Snug that up, really good and snug. And put your wrench on there just to hold it right where it's at. And then you're gonna tighten up your screw, Torx screw, nice and snug. Make sure that's very tight. And I'm gonna pull this guy out. It's a little bit snug. Let's see if it goes in. All right, so that's a little snug, but it definitely, if you go too hard, you can actually, yeah, that's actually very good. So it's not, it's a little tight right there, but we also have 1000s each way to not have to worry about it. I'm actually gonna, I think I might loosen that up just a little bit. So I'm gonna loosen this guy up here. I'm gonna set my feeler gauge in because I can. If you guys are doing this on the ground in the machine, it's gonna be a little trickier doing it, but this is the correct way. If you can tighten it up on there, get your wrench and then tighten this guy up like that. And then we have, okay, so that's much better. It's still snug, but it's not as tight as it was. And that's 4/1000s. And then just make sure that you make sure these guys are nice and tight before you put it all back together again. Everybody out there with the yeah, this one here is a little loose, but this 3/5000s. I'm gonna leave that go. But that's pretty much how you adjust them. And I go in between, it says 3/5000s for this particular model. Every model can be different to a degree. It's not gonna be much difference. I've seen 4 to 6, 3 to 5. But you definitely want to get in between that. Now, I do know when you put the valve covers back on again, like I said about the valve covers, some of them actually have the, this one actually, we put the gasket back on, but if you have if you want to do the gasket, you can also make sure you go to the website for Briggs and Stratton, you can find the gasket. And I'm taking this off right now just to show you guys that this is very clean. You can take this whole, you can take all the goo off of it if you have goo on it, and you can clean them up on a wire wheel and get it nice and clean. And also you're going to have to use, I use a razor blade here to clean up all this. And you just have to be careful about any kind of droppings. You might want to put a paper towel in there or something, or a rag, so you don't drop anything on the inside. And pretty much that's it for adjusting the valves. We're going to go into the next stage of this project and open up the backside here for the camshaft, and that's going to be on another video. If everybody liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. I do appreciate everybody watching my videos. Please subscribe, and thanks for watching.